And the beast is back. Adhiban, after a disappointing start in round one, made a comeback with a smashing win today in round two of the Gibraltar Masters. He joins us in our studio. Adhiban, back on track after a slow start yesterday. Yeah. You had a draw, but today's game was very nice.
Yeah, also before the round, Stuart came to me and he was like, the beast is back. And I think he didn't see my yesterday game. So yeah, I was like, okay, I should play well today, just for Stuart.
The beast really is back with this game. But first, tell us, how did you get this nickname?
Yeah, this I was trying to remember the origin story of beast, but I just could not. And yeah, I don't know, maybe it was started from Tata Steel, yeah. Tata Steel, where I started to play all this very interesting lines. And yeah, suddenly after that, I think I gained this name.
And you were very happy to keep it.
Yeah. No, I came up with a nickname of my own, but that generally doesn't stay. The name which people come up with, that is what stays forever.
And the name is very apt, as we could see with this game. But what happened? Where did black go very wrong in this? Was it at this moment because rook d6 seemed a bit shaky?
Yeah, I think maybe he has to give up the pawn somehow, because I'm getting this threat with e4. So maybe something like...
So already things have gone a bit
wrong.
Yeah,
because
black.
I thought maybe king g7 was not so accurate. I thought maybe knight d6, but still... I have some pressure with queen h6. But here, yeah, I was just waiting for, like, whatever he does, even if he goes b5, I go e4. And the point was this. And
so after bishop e4,
before
you
knight,
jump
g5,
with the knight.
Yeah, this was the point. And suddenly, he has to take. Otherwise, b7 is hanging.
This is quite nice because everything's
Yeah.
Everything's hanging. And if you take on g5,
yeah,
you
bishop
just
e4,
take on...
And yeah, he has to go rook b8. And he's like in zugzwang there. I go rook d1, rook b7. And
you
yeah.
could also get your king all the way up if you wanted, because nothing can
like
move.
Short, yeah.
But he went for rook d6 here, which didn't seem to help.
Yeah. I think he just missed this idea with e4 completely. And so yeah, after e4, I think it's...
Had you seen this motif before of e4?
No, I think I figured, like at first I thought it was not so good for me, because I didn't see how to attack actually. I thought I needed a lot of time, like h4, knight h2 or like something. But then when I found out e4, like I was very happy, because then like everything is very fast.
So can you explain to us how it went with e4 and what was your calculation like after e4?
Yeah, surprisingly it's like very easy after this, because if he takes, I go knight g5. And suddenly it's like just lost. He has no moves. Bishop g6 is like, I'll win this piece. And if he takes here, and bishop e4, and he just cannot save the piece. And e4, this is the point. I think what he did is probably the best. Yeah, rook c6, because if he moves the bishop, then I get e4, e5 and just crash.
This is interesting. I was thinking, what about bishop c6 here?
Yeah, e5, yeah. And also lost, yeah.
So again, everything hangs. The f7 pawn, the c6 bishop just collapses.
Yeah, here actually I was looking at some funny line, like here, and queen here, and now knight f7. And like all mating patterns.
Yeah, knight 8-6 is
coming. Yeah, knight 8-6 is coming. And if he plays h5, I'll probably win the queen if needed.
With just queen h8 and queen a8. Nice. So he can't go bishop c6 here, and after rook c6, it just...
Yeah, actually my original plan was queen e7. And yeah, the point is same. Yeah, bishop
same
e4, idea. I always have this knight g5. But surprisingly, he has this queen c8 move, which... suddenly goes for my queen, actually.
Oh, this is beautiful,
yeah.
Actually. After this, the point is
rook
c7, and your queen is trapped.
Yeah, something. You don't want this. So. Yeah, but the thing is, okay, it's probably still winning after this, and e5, I'm still probably winning, but it's not as clear as thing I wanted. So I thought, okay, queen f4 is... Okay, he has to play bishop c4, and here I was again looking at some nice lines like e5.
So you always just go e5 and open the position.
Yeah. No, because without e5, it's not easy to break his position, because somehow it's defending. So here he has to take and check. Here I was thinking some queen g5, and just I'm giving everything. Like here, check, and here a knight e5.
Yeah.
Because otherwise it's not so clear. Knight e5, knight f7, and then I take the queen.
Right.
So.
You mean if king c7, you take the queen?
King c7, yeah, probably I just take
the queen. I mean, if king d6, then you take on f7,
yeah,
and you take the queen, right?
Yeah.
And then it was all over after this, because now you've got a really nice stack picking with knight e5.
Yeah, probably there are other moves which are also winning, but this, once I saw that this is winning by force, I just thought I'll go for it. Knight e5, yeah. And yeah, after this, I think, yeah, there's no defense, just... the bishop joins and okay, everything is collapsing. And mainly, I think the main source of problem is the knight on b7 actually. Yeah, I think it never got into the game.
And also with a move like e4 and e5, the bishop on g2 suddenly became a demon in all the lines.
Yeah, that's true.
And now after a result like yesterday, which probably was a slightly disappointing start, feels good to come back with such a win?
Yeah, sure. And also, no, it was funny. I was clearly winning and then I was clearly losing. Yesterday. At some point I was worse, but then finally it was draw. So it was like a mixed feeling, not entirely bad or...
Alright, well, still early days, long tournament to go. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, thanks. And nice dress.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yeah, bye.